Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. We start with the end of an era for Vermont Yankee. The 42-year-old nuclear power plant is starting the process of powering down this morning and will likely be disconnected from the grid by the end of the day. The move has been in the works since last year, though the facility likely won't be dismantled for at least another 30 years or so. The closing will cost the tri-state area, including Cheshire County here in New Hampshire, about 1,200 direct and indirect jobs. And studies have shown the plant provided about $500 million to the region each year. Three men faced charges this morning in connection with a series of burglaries and thefts in the town of Washington over the last couple of months. In all, police say there were 10 crimes in the area of Bailey Road and Woodpecker Road starting back in October. 32-year-old Levi Fogg and 31-year-old Phineas Fogg each face burglary and conspiracy charges. And 27-year-old Gary Valley Jr. is charged with criminal liability for conduct of another. Police say more charges are possible. And Rochester police are looking for the man in these pictures. Officers say he walked off with an iPad someone left behind on a bus. The owner of the iPad says she forgot to grab it on her way to work. Police say if you take something that isn't yours, even if it appears to be abandoned, it's still a crime and you're supposed to report the lost item. State police are trying to figure out why a man crashed his car off the side of Route 101 in Candia yesterday morning. Investigators say 23-year-old Brian Colbert was heading west just before 7 o'clock when he went off the side of the road. Police say he was not wearing a seatbelt and was thrown from his car. Colbert died at the scene. Just months after a local woman died suddenly, her family is now setting up a scholarship in her name. Kayla Bertolami would have been a senior at St. Anselm College studying computer science, something her family says she loved. She died in July after suffering a pulmonary embolism. Her mother tells us she was a great student and friend. A scholarship fund has been set up in Kayla's memory through the New Hampshire Charitable Foundation. Money will be given to local students who need help paying for school and who have similar goals to Kayla.
We wanted to make sure that it was available to New Hampshire students, people who were serious about education, as my daughter was, as our daughter was, and give back to the community.
I think it's a great way to honor her because that's basically what she was working for, school, school and work. That's all she did.
A link to donate to the fund will be posted on the New Hampshire Charitable Foundation's website in about a week. The family needs to raise $25,000 to get the fund up and running. Again, in about a week, a link to donate to the scholarship will be posted on the New Hampshire Charitable Foundation website. Their goal is to have at least that amount raised by March 20th, which would have been Kayla's 22nd birthday. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.